It's been widely reported that the US has intelligence indicating that Russia paid bounties or offered to pay bounties to Taliban fighters to kill American soldiers. Right. You had a phone call with Vladimir Putin on July 23rd. Did you bring up this issue?
No, that was a phone call to discuss other things. And frankly, that's an issue that many people said was fake news.
Who said it was fake news?
I think a lot of people, if you look at some of the wonderful folks from the Bush administration, some of them, not any friends of mine, were saying that it's a fake issue. But a lot of people said it's a fake issue.
There was
well, we had a call. We had a call talking about nuclear proliferation, which is a very big subject, where they would like to do something, and so would I. We discussed numerous things. We did not discuss that, no.
And you've never discussed it with him?
I have never discussed it with him, no. I would. I'd have no problem with it.
But you don't believe
but you know,
the intelligence.
It never
it's because you don't believe the intelligence. That's why.
Everything, you know, it's interesting. Nobody ever brings up China. They always bring Russia, Russia, Russia. If we can do something with Russia in terms of nuclear proliferation, which is a very big problem, bigger problem than global warming, a much bigger problem than global warming in terms of the real world, that would be a great thing. No, it never reached my desk. You know why? Because they didn't think it was intelligence. They didn't think it was real.
It was
they
in your written brief, though.
They didn't think it was worthy of it. I wouldn't mind. If it reached my desk, I would have done something about it. It never reached my desk because...
Do you read your written brief?
I do. I read a lot.
Really?
You know, I read a lot. They like to say I don't read. I read a lot.
Your daily
I comprehend extraordinarily well, probably better than anybody that you've interviewed in a long time. I read a lot. I spend a lot of time with... at meetings, usually it's once a day or at least two or three times a week intelligence
meetings.
Because
this was apparently
talking about India, talking about with the problems with China, talking about so many different elements of the world. Mm-hmm. The world is a very angry place. If you look all over the world, we call up, I see 22 soldiers were killed in India with China fighting over the border. It's been raging for many, many decades. And they've been fighting and back and forth. I have so many briefings on so many different countries, but this one didn't reach my desk.
The reason I say this is even if you don't believe this particular piece of intelligence, and there is dispute, no doubt there is dispute in the intelligence community about it, your former, John Nicholson, former head of forces in Afghanistan, said, and this is when he was working for you, that Russia is supplying weapons to the Taliban. Isn't that enough to challenge Putin over the killings of
US
soldiers?
Well, we supplied weapons when they were fighting Russia, too. You know, when the Taliban, in Afghanistan...
It's a different era.
Well, it's a different... I'm just saying, yes.
But does that...
Just saying we did that, too.
But how does that...
I don't know. I didn't ask Nicholson about that. He was there for a long time, didn't have great success because, you know, he was there before me, and then ultimately I made a change.
But you surely heard that, right? I mean, it's well known in the intelligence community that they're arming the Taliban, Russia.
I don't know. When you say arming, is
supplying
the Taliban
weapons.
Paying or are they giving
Russia
them?
Is supplying weapons and money to the Taliban.
I have heard that, but it's never, it's never reached my desk.
I mean, he said it on the record when he was in...
Hey, Russia doesn't want anything to do with Afghanistan. Let me just tell you about Russia. Russia used to be a thing called the Soviet Union. Because of Afghanistan, they went bankrupt. They became Russia, just so you do understand, okay? The last thing that Russia wants to do is get too much involved with Afghanistan. They tried that once. It didn't work out.